Morning, welcome back to my kitchen. We got a lovely sweet treat on the menu today, caramel oat squares made with Haraway's rolled oats. For this, I'm going to be using, as well as the rolled oats, I've got some butter, some chopped walnuts, an egg, vanilla essence, baking powder and baking soda, and some flour, and something super yummy, the sweetened condensed milk. In my saucepan here, I'm going to heat up a tin of sweetened condensed milk. We'll just look at that. That is so satisfying to watch that pouring in. 2 tablespoons of golden syrup. Pour that in. I'm going to also add 100 grams of butter, which I've just got cubed up here. I'm going to bring it to the boil so it will thicken up, and then we're going to leave it to cool down. And this is our delicious caramel filling. As I said, we're using Haraway's rolled oats in the base. Love using rolled oats in baking. 100% New Zealand oats, these ones. Been milled in the South Island for more than 150 years. So nutritious and versatile. This is thickened up a little bit and it's come to the boil. So I'm just going to leave it to one side. Into a bowl, I've got an egg here. Brown sugar rather than white in this one. So about 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla essence. So that's mixed together well. I've got 2 cups of flour. I do really like walnuts in this slice. You could use other nuts if you prefer. I've got 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder and 1/2 teaspoon, oops, sorry, not very elegant, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda as well. Just stir this through and then we'll add the rest of our ingredients. I've got 125 grams of melted butter and 1.5 cups of Haraway's rolled oats. And we're gonna tip in about 3/4 of our OT crumble. So keep back about 1/4 top. So we'll just push this down. I use the back of my fingers. Easy. And then we are gonna pour on our cooled caramel filling. See if I can do this with one hand. Yum. So just spread the filling out. Oh, so sticky. And then we'll sprinkle over that reserved part of our oaty crumble mixture. Then that is ready to go into the oven. Takes about 1/2 hour and we've got the oven preheating at 175. Here are my finished caramel oat squares, just 30 minutes in the oven. Left them to cool a little bit and then slice them up. Look at this. We've got the oaty base, a delicious caramel layer, and then a crumbly oaty topping. This is going to go perfect with a cuppa. We've got the Haraway's rolled oats and some walnuts in there too to counteract the sweetness. A really delicious slice. You can get this recipe and others on the Haraway's website.